The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 4th chapter, text number 10, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on August 2nd, 1974, in Vrindavan, India.
Ditarago Bhayakrodha Manamaya Mamupasita Bhavo Dhanatamsa Puta Manupabam Bhavam. Bhavam means nature also. Just like we call nature Sabhav, Sabhav. So Madhbhavam, this is one nature, this material nature, and this is also Krishna's Bhavam, means Krishna's nature. Nothing is beyond Krishna, but this is external nature. Bhumi rapahanaro bayu bhinna me prakriti astada. Bhinna means separated energy. The energy is working, although it is Krishna's nature, still it is separated nature. Just like I am speaking, it is being recorded. When it will be replayed, you will hear the same sound, but still it is separated from me. Similarly, this material nature is also Krishna's nature. Nothing is beyond Krishna. There are two natures, the spiritual nature and material nature. The material nature means external energy, and spiritual nature means internal energy. And we are also spiritual nature, margin. We can remain either in the material nature or in the spiritual nature. Therefore we are marginal nature. There are three natures, external, internal and margin. So long we are in the material nature, external nature, we are unhappy. This is the position. Just like a fish, when it is put into the land, it is unhappy or death. Similarly, if you, the creature of the land, if you are put in the water, you are unhappy and death. So because we belong to the spiritual nature, as it is explained by Krishna, that this material nature is apara. Apara means inferior, not fit for us. Therefore we are unhappy. So long we shall remain in the material nature, we must be unhappy. Just like this body. This body is made of material nature, and we are within this body. Dehinasmin jatha dehe kaumara jaumanam jara. So long we have got this body, material body, we must be unhappy. First of all, we must try to understand why we are unhappy. We are unhappy because we are in this material body. And what is an unhappiness? It is ending in four principles, janma, mrityu, jara, vyadhi. To take birth and again to die, and so long we live, we must suffer from some disease and we must become old. Plain truth. Therefore, intelligent person must be aware of the miserable condition of this material existence and try to get out of it. Is there any doubt? This is a fact. So, our only business is how to get out of this material existence. That is our only business. Not that how we can adjust things here and become happy. That is called karmi, fools. It is a fact that so long you will be here in this material world, however you may try to adjust things to become happy, it will be never possible. It will be never possible. They are trying to be materially happy in the Western world. They do not know actually what is happiness. But material happiness means sex life. So sex life there is every day enjoying, and still they go to the naked dance to see if there is happiness or why there is happiness. There cannot be any happiness. But this is adjustment. They are trying this way or that way. That's all. Puna puna chad vitachar banana. In the Bhagavad, the answer is they are all self-interested, but they do not know what is self-interest. Nati vidu sartha gatin hi Vishnu durasaya ji bahiratha manina. Bahiratha. Bahiratha means external energy, material energy. They are thinking by material adjustment they will be happy. But they do not know that self-interest is how to be connected with Vishnu, sarthagati. Nati vidu sarthagati means Vishnu. Or to become Vaishnav. Vishnu asya devata iti Vaishnav. Vaishnav means one who has accepted Vishnu as everything. As Krishna said, sarva dharmān parityajya mām ekaṁ saraṇaṁ bhaja. This is our business. But nobody is interested. Nati vidu. They do not know that this is the interest. This is the only interest. How to become reconnected with Krishna or Vishnu. Nati vidu. They do not know. Therefore, you have started this Krishna consciousness movement. They do not know. Everyone, 10%, the whole population of the world, they do not know. So rascal, so fool. They do not know their interest. Nati vidu sartha gatin hi Vishnu durasaya. Durasaya. With the hope against hope, which will be never fulfilled. That's what is called durasaya. Why? Bahiratha manina. They are interested in this external energy. So this is our problem. But the rascals, they do not know. Shastra. Therefore, you have to consult Shastra. What is our problem? We have to consult Shastra. And Shastra, how we can consult Shastra? Shastra, we have to go somebody who knows Shastra. Therefore, the basic injunction is Tadvijnanartham sa guru meva abhijacche srotriyam. If you want to know what is your actual interest, then you have to approach a guru. And who is guru? Srotriyam, who knows Shastra. Srotriyam. And not only knows, but the result must be there. Brahmanistham means Krishna consciousness. Brahmanistam means fully dependent on Krishna. This is the process. We must know, we must find out a guru who knows Shastra, the essence of Shastra. Vedas. What is the essence of Vedas? Vedanta. Vedanta means to know Krishna. Vedaisa sarvai ahameva vedam, Krishna says. All there are different types of Vedas. Sam, Yajuri, Kathadva, then 108 Upanishad, then Vedanta Sutra, then Puranas, Raman, Mahabharata, Vinshati, 20 kinds of Dharma Shastra, Manusangita, so many things. So, what is the purpose of all these Shastras? Krishna said, the purpose is to know me. And Vedanta, the Upanishad Tantranchi, jasmin vijnati sarvamedam vijnatam bhavanti. If you try to know Krishna, then, or if you understand Krishna, then you know everything. Jasmin vijnati sarvamedam vijnatam bhavanti. This is the knowledge to understand Krishna. And Krishna also confirms this. Janma karma me dibbam je janati tattva. Simply, if one understands tattva in truth, what I am, why I descend, why I became a child of Yashoda, why I became son of Vasudev, Janma, and why I act, why I take part in the battle, he has nothing to do. Natasya karjam karanam cha vidyate. Veda says, the Supreme Lord has nothing to do. Why he has to do? He is full, complete. He has nothing to do. He has nothing to aspire. There is nothing wanting. We are working for, because he wants so many things. But he has no want. He is atma-tripta, fully complete. Thus, he has nothing to do. Natasya karjam karanam cha vidyate. This is the description of God. He has nothing to do. Natasya karjam karanam cha vidyate, natasya sama udhikasya drishyate. There is nobody equal to him, nobody is greater than him. This is the basic description of God. Natasya karjam karanam cha vidyate, natasya sama. Sama means equal. And udhika. Udhika means greater. Here we find somebody is equal to you, somebody is greater than you, somebody is lower than you. Three positions. Everyone. Nobody can say that I am the final. Anybody. Beginning from Brahma down to the end. Everybody will find that somebody is equal to him, somebody is greater than him, and somebody is lesser than him. But Krishna, nobody is equal to him, nobody is greater than him, but everyone is lesser than him. This is Krishna. Everyone is lesser. Natasya karjam karanam cha, natasya sama udhikasya drishyate. Now you are in Krishna consciousness, studying of course so many books. Have you found anyone who is greater than Krishna or equal to Krishna? No. We can find one greater than Radharani. He is greater than Krishna. Yes. That is out of love. Actually, Radharani is also lesser than Krishna. She is Dasi, maidservant. She is always thinking how she shall be perfect Dasi. She is not thinking that Krishna sometimes makes Radharani greater than him. That does not mean Radharani thinks like that. Radharani always thinks how I shall become perfect maidservant of Krishna. That is the real position. Everyone. In the Chaitanya Charitamrita you will find how everyone is thinking of servant of Krishna. That is our real position. But Krishna sometimes elevates some of his devotees, just like Mother Yashoda. He is thinking Mother Yashoda is greater than me. Or he is making Mother Yashoda feeling like that I am protector of Krishna. If I do not feed Krishna nicely, he will die. This is called Vatsalya Rasa, paternal feeling. So nobody is greater than Krishna, actually. And she is feeling greater than Krishna as also made servant, that I must serve Krishna, I must kindly give Krishna food, I must kindly raise Krishna. Always taking care, always answers. Krishna may not be in danger, Krishna is crawling, he may not go to the water, he may not be attacked by the monkey, he may not be swimming, he is always answers. He is doing his household work, but he is always answers how to protect Krishna. So she is thinking that unless I give protection to Krishna, Krishna may be facing so many dangers. But Krishna is doing his business. Radharani, Mother Yashoda, keeping Krishna underneath the cart, and Krishna is baking the cart, killing the Sakatasur, and Mother Yashoda thinking Krishna is safe. Then when the cart was broken, the utensils scattered, she became anxious. Then this is Krishna's enjoyment to deal with his devotees in different rasas and enjoy. Sakha, Santa Dasa Sakha, Mahavidya, Vatsalya. In this way Krishna is all enjoying. He has no other business than enjoyment. Anandamaya Vyasat. He is by nature simply enjoying. England. That is Krishna. So, we are also Krishna's part and parcel. Therefore, in minute quantity, we have got the same propensities how to enjoy life. This is because we are Krishna's part and parcel. The same, just like the drop of seawater has the same chemical composition. Analyze the same percentage of salt proportionately, just like 2/50 proportion, which is called ratio. The ratio is the same, meaning small quantity. Otherwise, the percentage is the same, only in small quantity. We are Anandamaya, our nature is to remain always jubilant in pleasure. But because we are in this material contact, we are not jubilant. This is our problem. That Krishna is suggesting here, how to solve your problem. He says, Ditarāga. Give up this attachment, sense attachment, rāga. Rāga means attachment. Ditarāga bhaya. And here we have got one quality, that fear, always fearing. It's like we are having these railings. Why? We are afraid. We may not be attacked. The material life means ahara nidra bhaya maithuna. We must eat, we must sleep, and we must be afraid of, and we must have sex. This is material life. Ahara nidra bhaya maithuna. And spiritual life means minus this. no more fear, no more attachment, no more sex life. Just like in the life of the Goswamis. Nidyahara vihara kadi vijito. Conquer. Conquer over these things, material necessities. So, this is called penance. Here it is said. Bhavo jnana tapasa. First of all, jnana, understanding, our position. This is called jnana. And then practice tapasa. Tapasa means make these things, material necessities, zero. That is called tapasa. Tapasa. Because we are accustomed to all these things, eating, sleeping, making, and feeling. So to give up, it is not possible, all of a sudden. That is not possible, because we are accustomed. Just like the fan is rotating, if you stop the switch, it will rotate, at least for some time, because the force is there. Similarly, even if we accept that these things should be stopped, no more eating, no more sleeping, no more sex, no more fear, there must be determination. But it may go round because you have practiced it. Therefore, Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Apite Sudurācāro Bhajati Mamananna Bhāk Sādhuriva Samantam. If you take to Krishna consciousness fully, even due to our past habits, we are attached to all these things, Krishna says, it doesn't matter. But you keep yourself always in Krishna consciousness. What is that? Krishna consciousness, chant Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama. That will keep your Krishna consciousness. Bhajati mam anannabha. He does not forget to worship Krishna by chanting this Hare Krishna Mahamantra. If you do that, but don't be attached to all this eating, sleeping, making, and defending. But be detached that these things I do not require as spirit soul. But because I am in material condition, because I have got this body, to keep this body fit, I require these things to minimize it. Just like I am sannyasi, somebody is sannyasi. So sannyasi, what is the sannyasi? You are also eating, you are also sleeping. But there is no mating, no sex life. So one item, drop, at least. The very important item. So that is called vitarāga. And there is no fear. Vitarāga. Everything can be practiced. Abhyāsa yoga yuktena cita sādhāna kāmina. If we practice, then things will be all right. Therefore Krishna says that bahava, not one, bahava, Krishna says many, many persons. We have got many instances in the Shastras. By tapasā, brahmacaryena, tapasā, jnanena, jamena, niyamena, tyagena. These are the different items. But either you practice these different items or simply take to Krishna consciousness, all these practices will be automatically done. Kachit kevala bhakti yogena, vasudeva parayana. If you become vasudeva parayana, then these things will be practiced. Just like everyone in this country, in the morning, the manager of the central bank came, he was very much praising that how these European, American boys have become so nice? Because they have taken to bhakti yoga. You see, compared Miham, Mihar or Mibhavaskar. Mihara Mibhavaskar. Mihara means, what is called? Mr. Frost. In the morning sometimes. Fog, yes. The fog, we have got experience when there is fog. When I was going to your country, yes, I was on the sea, so there was all of a sudden fog covered all over the sea. Anyone who has traveled in the sea, they have got experience. So you cannot go. Immediately the ship stops and horns so that other ship may not collide. It becomes. So this fog, now you have no instrument to drive out the fog. But as soon as the sun rises a little, with strength, immediately fog is gone. So strong, but due to the sun sign, immediately it goes. Niharam eva bhaskar, this example is. Similarly, we may have so many bad habits, rava, attachment. If you simply take to Krishna consciousness, this will go, just like the fog, immediately. So take to Krishna consciousness very rigidly. That is called vitarava. Simply by this is the gift of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that Parang Vijayate Sri Krishna Sankirtanam Cheta Darpana Marjanam. Cheta Darpana Marjanam means to drive away the fog in the mind. That's all. Because you are covered by the fog in so many ways, and it is very difficult to drive away. But you keep yourself in Krishna consciousness, it will be recognized. It will be recognized. There is no doubt about it. Krishna is suggesting that, first of all, jnanam. These rascals have no knowledge how to become happy. They are thinking, he said, they will be happy by drinking wine and eating meat and having sex life unlimited. They're thinking, so rascal. The whole civilization is condemned. They do not know how to become happy. They do not know how to become happy. Murha. They do not know. The happiness is only in Krishna consciousness. This is a fact. Krishna assures that. That bahavo, many, jnana tapasa. First of all, one must know that the way in which you are finding out, trying to find out happiness, that is nonsense. That is not possible. We have to give up all these things. That is tapasa. Voluntarily give up all these things. The more you are advanced, means more you have given up all this. Eating, sleeping, making, independence. This is for you. So, vitarāga bhaya krodha, how it is possible? How to become detached? Manmaya. Always be absorbed in my thought. Or manmaya means, man means mind, maya, of me, thinking of me, and that is recommended. Manmana bhava madhvakta madhiraji maha namaskuru. This is the path. Always think of Krishna, manmana, and this is easy. It's like you love somebody, so if you chant his name, if you think of him, you always remember Similarly, if you simply think of Krishna, if you simply chant Hare Krishna name, then you remain manmaya. So, vitarāga bhayakrodha manmaya mām upāsthita. You should take shelter of Krishna. Krishna advises, sarva-dharmān paritarjya māmekaṁ saraṇaṁ braja. You take my shelter. So, of course, those who are thinking of Krishna, it is understood that he has taken shelter of Krishna. Manmaya. Manmaya mām upāsthita. So, if you do these things, not only you, there are many examples, bahava, just like Prahlad Maharaj, Vibhu Maharaj, or big stalwart devotees, Narad Muni, Brahma, Svayambhu, Narada, Sambhu, Kumara, Kapila, Prahlada, Bhishma, they are big personalities. To follow them, how Prahlad Maharaj was being chastised by his father 5 years before, but he did not know how to protest. He was suffering and chanting Hare Krishna. What can be done? What can be done? He was completely dependent on his father, and father had no mercy. The only fault was he Krishna conscious. That is his fault. And he was being punished. This is the world. Even father will be enemy. What to speak of others? If you become Krishna conscious, the whole world will be your enemy. You must be prepared for that. Therefore you require tapasya. Tapasya means voluntarily agree to suffer. That is called suffering. Voluntary. Suffering is there. But why not suffer for Krishna? Everyone is unhappy. Everyone is in suffering condition. Who is not suffering? Everyone is suffering. Pitav jantana, adhyatri, adhi bhauti, adhi dvaibhi. Three kinds of sufferings are always going on. While you are running fan, because suffering, there is heat. So, where is no suffering? This is called adhidvaivi, the scorching heat, the scorching, severe cold. There must be always. We are suffering now due to scorching heat. And when we are thinking, if it has become cooler, and when it is cool, then also is suffering. Then we think, if there is some heat, when there is winter, we are hankering after heat, and when there is summer, we are hankering after cooling. So this is why we cannot be happy. First of all, we must know that there is no question of happiness here. We are simply hankering. If you would have been very nicely cool, and when it is cool, then you think, if it has been nicely hot, the same thing. Charbita charvanana. Charbita charvanana means chewing the chew. You have tasted heat and cold both, but you are discerning. If it had been like this, even like that, even. But never come to the conclusion that either heat or cool, we have to suffer. Matras parshastra pauntya, that is explained by Krishna. So long you have got this material skin, then this heat and cold, you will have to suffer. Matras parshastra pauntya, sitosna sukadukkada. The sita, the summer, the winter, or the summer season, neither of them are sources of happiness. But you are thinking like that. If it would have been like this, it would have been like this. Therefore, kankha, akankha. So, if you become transcendentally situated, brahma-bhuta, there will be no more akankha. there will no more hankering either for this or that, because he knows. That is called jnana. So after jnana, that is required. Jnana in the human form of life, this knowledge is required. The animals cannot have jnana. The human being can have that. This is knowledge. That so long I possess this material body, I will have to suffer. Unless you come to this conclusion, there is no progress. If we remain attached to this bodily pains and pleasure, of course nobody wants pains, but for pleasure, we take to Krishna consciousness, of course gradually we will come to knowledge. That is not our aim. Our aim is that the pains and pleasure, so-called pleasure, actually pain, this will continue so long we have got this body. Therefore, we have to practice tapasa, penance, simple thing. No illicit sex, no meat eating, no gambling, no interest. This is tapasa. Voluntarily accepting those who are practiced to all these bad habits, so they feel some pain, but you accept that pain. Then this pain will be over, this material pain. It's like sometimes for curing some disease, the doctor says that injection or surgical operation, that is painful. But to cure the disease, we should accept that pain. Similarly, if you want to become free from this material body, then you should accept this pain. This is not pain, it is simply imagination. Actually, it is pleasure. So, because you have no knowledge, therefore jnana tapasa. And if there is knowledge and if there is tapasa, penance, then puta pilipa. You become pilipa. That's what he said. Bhava jnana tapasa puta madhavam agata. Then you come back to home. So, this Krishna consciousness movement is for teaching how one can be detached from this material existence and voluntarily accepting some suffering. We should be steady, but actually there is no suffering. It is simply imagination. It is like there are many meat eaters. We do not eat meat. So what is our suffering? It is simply imagination. If you ask the meat eater that don't eat meat, he says, oh, this is horrible. He'll say, horrible. Yes, actually they say. I mean, big man, the Lord Jetman, he also said, no, this is cannot be. This is our life. Lord Jetman, to some of our God brothers, also, can you make me Brahmin? Yes, we can make you Brahmin. You give us no, this is not possible. Horrible. It appears to be horrible because we are so much absorbed in Maya. As soon as you ask anybody that you cannot eat meat, he'll think it, oh, this is horrible. As soon as you say you cannot drink, you cannot have any intoxication, he thinks it is horrible. But actually this is Maya. It is not horrible, but you are thinking horrible. We are not eating meat. Are you dying? No. There are so many nice foodstuffs. Why should I eat meat? So, Param Vishnu Nivartate. So our philosophy, our Vaishnava philosophy, we do not say only that don't eat this, but eat this. You do not enjoy this, but enjoy this. We give one alternative. We are not simply zero. The Mayavadi philosophy is zero. We say they make this side zero and take this positive side. Just like here. Vitarāga bhayakrodhā manmā māmā upāsita bhava jñāna jñāna pūta madbhava madata. He did give up this, but that does not mean he became zero. Zero is sunna body, body. No, you cannot remain in zero. That is not possible. If you accept this void philosophy to make everything zero, that is artificial, then again you will fall down, because you cannot remain in zero. The Mahavadi philosopher, the Buddhist philosopher, they want to make things zero. That is not possible. You cannot remain in zero, because you are Anandamaya Vyasa. You want ananda, pleasure. Pleasure cannot be in zero. That is not possible. Is it possible? To make things zero and enjoy? No, that is not possible. Therefore, Krishna says that param drishtya nivartate. You can make zero automatically when you find better investment. So you have to give better investment. Then things will be zero. Because you have got better investment, you are not interested to go to the hotel. There is hotel also, cinema also in Vrindavan. Better. Will you go there? So if you become attached to Krishna consciousness, this hotel, restaurants and dancing and this and that, they will be zero. Automatic. But if you simply try to make it zero, that is not possible. That is not possible. Therefore, param drishtya nivartate, if you get better engagement, to try to engage yourself always in the better engagement, then this material activity is the zero. But zero is not our philosophy. Positive, not negative. They simply make negative. Negative will not help us. Negative, there is a requisition of negativeness. But here it is said that one is vitaraga bhayakrodha. You have to be detached from all these nonsense things. But the result will be, by jnana tapasa, by knowledge and penance and austerities, when you will be purified, then you will come back to me. This is positive. This is positive. Our philosophy is positive, not negative. Negative is, I want to say, that is, what is called? Annoy Bhattirevi, Sanskrit. Direct and indirect. This is indirect method. Direct method is positive. So you will be positively engaged in Krishna consciousness, in Krishna service, then you will always remain on the transcendental platform, making the material activities zero. That is one. Thank you very much.